Okay, in this video, we are going to be talking about approval ratings. And approval ratings is when voters have the opportunity to choose choices that they like as opposed to what is their favorite. Because you can run into a situation where you may not vote for a particular person as your first place choice, but that doesn't mean you wouldn't approve of maybe them being chosen to be in first place after a particular method has been applied. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, we're going to go ahead and start with a basic preference schedule. So I'm just going to go ahead and make one real quick. A, B, C, and D. D, B, C, and A. B, C, D, and A, and lastly, all right, so here's our basic example of our preference schedule, okay? Remember that first place is always going to be on top, going all the way down to your last place here, okay? So if we were going to try to figure out the approval ratings, meaning who has the largest approval ratings, and what we would do is, first off, we have to choose. So in your problem, it would say, what if everybody approved of their first choice and then their third choice? Okay. Now, this information will always be given to you, so you always know what place you're actually dealing with. Now, when you're dealing with approval ratings, first off, we got to go ahead and get our scores down, A, B, C, D. This is going to be where we're going to have our little scorecard that tells us our winner. Whoever is located within the first and third place of each column will receive the 10 votes at the bottom. So notice how A and C are the places that have been approved. So that means A would get 10 votes and then C would also get 10 votes. And you keep a running total. So for the next column, D and C would get 15. So that's 15 and C would get an additional 15. Next one would be B and D. So B would get 20 and then D would get 20. And lastly, for our final one, C and B would both get 25. So this is 25, and this right here is 25. And of course, you would total them. That would give me 50, and this right here, I believe, will give me 60. So D is our overall approval ratings winner. All right, let's try it one more time. In this case, we are going to change it up, and rather than saying first and third, we are going to choose another place. In this case, we're going second and third. Okay, second and third. So the same setup. You have your official scorecard over here because you need to keep record of how many votes each candidate or choice is being approved on. So let's see, A is not in your first choice, but notice that is in column 2, 3, and 4, so I would say that's 15 plus 20 plus 25, because A had been chosen three times. For B, let's see, B's here, so that's 10 and 15, so that's 10 plus 15. C is there, which C is going to have 20, and then D is 35, but we'll just do it the long way and say 25. There we go. So who wins here? Well, very simply, we just add what we have. That is 60 for A, and then this is going to be 25. This is going to stay 20, and this is going to be 35. So in this case, if we were working off a problem where everybody approved of their second and fourth place choice, then A would be our winner. And we're going to try one more, and then we'll be done with this video. Okay, this is our last problem here, and so I just decided to change it up, and now it's a preference schedule amongst Tom, George, Bill, Joe, and Ed. All right, so what we're going to do is we are going to select our approval here, and I'm just going to say everybody approves of their first, their third, and then their last categories, okay? That's who everybody agrees with. So in this case, since three have been selected, that means that three people will be receiving the votes at the bottom per column. So if you want to go ahead and pause it, feel free to pause the video right now to try to figure it out. If not, just keep it playing and we'll go ahead and figure it out. So let's go ahead and get our scorecard off to the side here. So that's Tom. All right. So now you can either have the choice of going through column by column, or you can just kind of observe how many times each person is mentioned. So like Tom is only marked one time, so Tom would get 200 here. And let's see, George is next. Let's see, George is marked right here. Oh, that's the only time George is. That's 250. All right, let's see, Bill. Oh, Bill's marked three times, one, two, and three. So that's going to be 200 plus 250 plus 225, running out of room here. Let's see, Joe is here and here, and that's it. So Joe is going to be 250 and plus 225. And I'm sorry, I put that for Ed. Let's see, let's try this again. 250 plus 225. And lastly, Ed is, Ed's right here, and then Ed's right here. As you get more experience with this process, there's more than one way to figure out all the votes. So I just kind of showed you all three. So let's see, all right, so after we total, Tom has 200. Let me do that one again. So Tom has 200 votes. Oh, that's even worse. But all right, George has 250. Let's see, Bill, let's see, 225. I think that is 675. I got to write off to the side here. Joe is 475, if I'm not mistaken. And lastly, Ed is 425. So our winner would be Bill. He would be the overall approval winner. And if you have any questions, please let me know the next time you see me. Thank you.